Hello friends, welcome to Freshers Live.
Today is 21st Jan 2019.
Here, I will discuss all the important questions that may be asked from today's current affairs and important facts related with each question. So watch this video very carefully and try to answer the questions as at the end of the video. You can download the PDF of the video from the link provided in the description. You can also download the PDF from our website as well as our WhatsApp groups. So let's start.
The first question for today is, Prime Minister Narendra Modi inaugurated first National Museum of Indian Cinema in Dash. The answer for this question is A. Mumbai. Now let us know something about the National Museum of Indian Cinema. It was built under the guidance of the Museum Advisory Committee headed by noted filmmaker Shyam Benegal. It is an innovation committee headed by lyricist Prasoon Joshi. It was also constituted to provide an upgrade to NMIC, that is National Museum of Indian Cinema. The building has four exhibition halls. First, Mahatma Gandhi and his impact on Indian cinema. Second, children's film studio. Third, technology creativity. And fourth, vibrant cinematographic culture across India. Now let us know about the objective of the museum. The main objective of the museum is to take its visitors through an absorbing journey of over a century of Indian cinema in a storytelling mode with the help of visuals, graphics, artifacts, interactive exhibits, and multimedia expositions. The second question is, which union minister inaugurated the Diffu Bridge over Chippu River in Arunachal Pradesh? Therefore, the answer for this question is A. Srimati Nirmala Sitharaman. Friends, first let us know for what is the Diffu Bridge constructed. The Diffu Bridge is constructed in order to provide an interrupted access between Dibang Valley and Lohit Valley region of eastern Arunachal Pradesh. The bridge is about 426 meters in length. Something about the BRO, that is Border Roads Organization. The Border Roads Organization constructed the bridge along Indo-China border. The construction of the bridge began in 2011. The total cost to build the bridge was ₹4,847.83 lakhs and was funded by the Union Ministry of Road Transport and Highways. The bridge will make travelling from east part to west part of Arunachal Pradesh very convenient and time-saving. The third question is, who is the president of Afghanistan? The question is asked because of Afghanistan's upcoming presidential election. While preparing, learn by heart the ruling parties and politicians and pen down the important leaders of the world. The answer for this question is C. Ashraf Ghani. A few points about Afghanistan. The presidential election has been planned to be held in the month of July 2019. Afghan's current president Ashraf Ghani formally registered as a candidate for Afghanistan's delayed presidential election. The president is Ashraf Ghani. The chief executive officer is Abdullah Abdullah. The capital is Kabul and the currency is Afghani. The next question is, Indian Railways RailTel project functions under Dash Initiative. The answer for this question is B. Digital India Initiative. Contributing towards fulfillment of PM's Digital India Initiative, the Indian Railways has one of the world's largest public Wi-Fi networks in RailWire Wi-Fi. Mini Ratna Central PSU, that is public sector undertaking under the Ministry of Railways, is provided by RailTel. The Indian Railways decided to provide A1 and C category railway stations across the country. Across 746 railway stations in India, RailWire Wi-Fi has been set up with around 2.6 crore users login in association with Google as the technology partner. The RailTel has provided high-speed Wi-Fi in a month and over 9,491 tetrabyte of aggregated data consumption. Something about the Railway Ministry. It was formed in the year 16 April 1853 and is headquartered at New Delhi. The minister is Piyush Goyal and the deputy minister is Manoj Sinha. The fifth question is, which state recently announced extension of free health services under Biju Swasthya Kalyan Yojana? The answer is A. Odisha. Come, let us know something about Biju Swasthya Kalyan Yojana. This was launched on 15th August 2018 by the Odisha government. This scheme provides free medical services to all at government colleges and hospitals irrespective of the category of the patients without any requirement of income, residence or any other document. The scheme received an overwhelming response. Until now, over 2.25 crore people have availed free treatment under the scheme. Odisha CM Shri Navin Patnaik announced the extension of free health services under this Yojana to all medical colleges and hospitals of Odisha from 1st February 2019. The sixth question is, which company combines with Lipcoin to build India's first lithium-ion gigafactory? It is D. Bharat Heavy Electricals Limited, commonly known as BHEL, which is ready to combine with Lipcoin to build India's first lithium-ion gigafactory. Now it's time to know few facts about Lipcoin. Lipcoin is a cryptocurrency library based on the Bitcoin. It maintains a version of Bitcoin that is 100% compatible. Lipcoin is based on CMake and supports builds of static and dynamic libraries and dynamic libraries on Linux, Mac OS X and Windows, etc. Now, what is a Bitcoin? Bitcoin is an innovative payment network and a new kind of money. Friends, now let us see for what they are implementing this project. The main aim of the project is to create integrated manufacturing ecosystem resulting in self-reliance and lower cost. This project will include made by India for India with focus on core cost component manufactured domestically. The cutting edge digital technologies is to replace high capex and high opex processes will be the highlight of this project in India. The seventh question is, for what age categories of Indians did the Home Ministry make Aadhaar cards valid travel documents to Nepal and Bhutan? The answer is B, below 15 and above 65. The Indian citizens who are going to Nepal and Bhutan don't need a visa if they hold a valid passport, a photo identity card issued by the Government of India or an election ID card issued by the Election Commission. Recently, Home Ministry made an announcement that Indians below 15 and above 65 can use Aadhaar cards to travel to Nepal and Bhutan. Let us learn something about Visa and Aadhaar card. It was formed on 15th August 1947. It is headquartered at New Delhi. The minister responsible is Rajnath Singh. Various departments under Home Ministry, that is the child agencies, are Intelligence Bureau, Central Reserve Policy Force, Border Security Force, Indo-Tibetan Border Police and National Security Guards. Friends, it will be good if you memorize the departments with their abbreviations. The eighth question is, who is the new Sweden Prime Minister elected for a second term? The answer is C. Stefan Löfven. Let us see a few details about Stefan Löfven. He succeeded his second attempt to form government with 153 votes while 115 votes against him. The government is formed in coalition with the Green Party and in budget cooperation with Centre Party and the Liberals. The Prime Minister is expected to formally present his new government and its full program on Monday. It will be one of the weakest administrations in Sweden in 70 years, with just 32.7% of voters having cast ballots for the two parties. The next question is, who won the International Tennis Federation ITF Women's Tennis Tournament in Singapore? The answer is A. Ankita Raina.
Let us know something about International Tennis Federation. It was formed on 1st March 1913. It is headquartered at London, UK. The president of ITF is David Hegarty. It is the governing body of world tennis, wheelchair tennis, and beach tennis. It is affiliated with 211 national tennis associations and 6 regional associations. The 10th question is, which of the following city has been named as the World Capital of Architecture for 2020? The UN Educational, Scientific and Cultural Organization, UNESCO, has named the Brazilian city of Rio de Janeiro as the World Capital of Architecture for 2020. Therefore, the answer is B, Rio de Janeiro. Something about the city. Rio will be the first city to receive the title under a program launched together by UNESCO and the International Union of Architects in November 2018. It was formed in the year November 1946. It is headquartered at Paris, France. Member countries 193 and 11 associate members. The head is Audrey Azoulay. The purpose of UNESCO is to contribute to peace and security by promoting international collaboration through educational, scientific and cultural reforms. The question for today is, Indians below 15 and above 65 are allowed to use Aadhaar as passport proof to dash and dash countries. The answer is D, Nepal and Bhutan countries.
Okay friends, that's for today. Thanks for watching our video. If you find information provided in our video useful, please do like, share and subscribe our YouTube channel. Follow us regularly to stay updated with daily current affairs.